I'm going to describe an interactive simulation that is available on the Wolfram Demonstration Project site, and it uses the van der Waals equation of state to generate isotherms on a PV diagram and to generate isobars on a TV diagram. On the left, we plot the log of the pressure versus the log of the volume. On the right, we're plotting temperature versus the log of the volume. So the blue line on the left and on the right corresponds to the van der Waals equation of state, including the dashed blue line. The dashed blue line, however, does not correspond to physical reality. And instead, if we look on the left side, we can see I've circled the purple circles, the points where we draw a horizontal line corresponding to constant pressure and constant temperature that connects the liquid phase and the vapor phase that are in equilibrium at this temperature. And so the physical representation in this two-phase region really corresponds to any point along this dashed line, this horizontal dashed line, is some fraction of liquid and some fraction of vapor. The location of this horizontal line is determined by setting fugacities in the liquid and the vapor phase equal. Also, could be determined on a linear plot by setting this green area above the line equal to the green area below the line. But notice the areas are not equal because this is a log plot. On a linear plot, those areas would be equal. Now, the right side shows the corresponding temperature volume diagram and an isobar. Now we can't say areas are going to be equal, but again, its fugacities are equal that determine the horizontal line. And on the right side, we can change the pressure and change the location of this isobar. On the left side, we can change the temperature and therefore look at a different isotherm. So we'll go and look at the interactive simulation to get a little better understanding of these pressure volume and temperature volume diagrams. Remember, this is for a single component that we're modeling by a cubic equation of state. So here's the interactive simulation. I'm looking at the pressure volume diagram. And as I change the temperature, of course, the isotherm moves up. Vapor liquid equilibrium moves to higher pressure. Again, these green areas on a linear plot of pressure versus volume would be the same size area. And if I increase the temperature enough, now that's at the critical temperature, and then we move higher up or above the critical temperature in a supercritical region up at the higher pressures, and then we're in the vapor region at the lower. So now all the points on the blue line correspond to physical meaningful values, whereas, of course, in the two-phase region, we draw this horizontal line that connects, and as we lower the temperature, we lower the saturation pressure, the equilibrium pressure where the horizontal line is located. And then on a temperature volume diagram, now we're looking at an isobar, and as we raise the pressure, of course, we go to higher temperature, higher saturation temperature, and sufficiently high pressure. Again, we have a graph that represents all the points correspond to physical realities. So you can use this to get a little better understanding of how this cubic equation state, in this case the van der Waals equation state, can model the properties of a real single component.